the most important thing that you can do to ensure that you're caring for and loving your doodle in the best way possible is... Yes! Hey guys, welcome to another dog vlog! And in today's video, I am going to tell you how to care for your golden doodle or labradoodle puppy, right? Meow. Oh, and if you are new here, welcome. I am so happy to have you here as part of our, you and I's, dog vlog, because this vlog is all about saving all the damn dogs. So if you want to be part of our mission, click that subscribe button down below. The first thing that you need to think about when you're caring for a doodle, and this is probably one of the most obvious things, is their coat. I mean, look at those curls and those waves. Although beautiful, do you know what that means? Do you know what all of these waves and curls mean to a dog owner? You are going to need a collection of slicker brushes, regular brushes, and a comb at the minimum to be able to maintain, to be able to maintain their coat. Why, do you ask? Because they have curly coats that tangle like nobody's freaking business. And I knew this going in when we adopted him. I had researched it, I had friends that have doodles, so I knew it going in, but it still did not prepare me for how often I would have to comb and brush him. And on top of that, y'all, they are gonna have to go to either a professional groomer or have you groom them with clippers and trim their coat on average every 4 to 8 weeks. The other thing to consider when you have a doodle is that they are most of the time super duper high energy, which matches my personality, because if you can't tell, I have a lot of energy, almost like that of a lab. Some doodles though, golden doodles and labradoodles, hey, sit, are super high energy. So you need to be prepared to exercise them every single day. It doesn't matter rain or shine. It can be physical exercise like training, it can be physical exercise like walking them, playing fetch with them, or mental exercise like training them or mental stimulation games. Oh, this is a good tip. I put his food in here, which we'll talk about food in a minute, because that is, quite frankly, I would say the second most important thing. I still haven't gotten to the most important thing yet. I'll get to that in a minute. But because they are super high active, they're great for people like me who likes to go on walks every day and jogs sometimes. When I say jog, I use that term loosely. But a benefit of their hyperactivity is that they are also, in my experience, extremely smart. At least my dude is. He loves to work. He's very food motivated. I have some dehydrated, this is, I think, beef liver with tripe. I think that's what this is, yeah. And he is just super motivated by food. So working with him and training him is a breeze. You wanna show them some tricks, Fan? Okay, high five. Yes, good boy. As you can see, he loves working, especially for food. If you are looking for a dog that wants to please you, wants to constantly have a job to do, you will be a great caregiver to a doodle. One important part of taking care of your doodle is giving them lots and lots of love and attention. They just want to be loved on. They want their belly scratched. It's always good to touch their paws. Look how cute his paws are. The best places to touch your dude are their chest. Sometimes they like their neck. A lot of times they like their ears rubbed. They don't typically love their face manhandled. See, he's like, I don't want my face. I don't want my face. I still practice touching it so that he's used to it, but that's not something they necessarily love. And then, oh, look at Tia. He's such a love bug. Hi. and then also their back. He likes his back. You super playful. You super playful. Hi. Oh, and here's a pro tip. Pro tip alert. Pro tip. Pro tip. Take your dog to the vet frequently. And hear me out, hear me out. I don't mean for an appointment. When you take your puppy to the vet for their first checkup appointment, ask your vet, be like, hey, would it be okay if I, with permission, bring my dog to the vet every once in a while, maybe once a week in the beginning, just to get weighed, to come in and get treats, and just to get used to the environment. That is so beneficial so that your dog becomes comfortable with the veterinarian and they're not scared every time they go in. Okay, so the second most important thing when caring for your doodle, and in a second I'm going to tell you the most important thing, but the second most important thing when caring for your doodle is their diet, what you feed them, their food. I have so many videos about this. I will link the playlist up here of the foods and the type of foods that I, and treats even, that I recommend for your doodle. And this is so important because studies have actually shown that golden retrievers and even Labradors in some cases are prone to get cancer. Cancer is an epidemic in dogs, and you want to know one of the most important ways that you can help prevent and slow the growth of cancer in your dog and even other diseases. It is choosing the best and ideal, most bioavailable, nutritious diet possible. And you all know what that is. If you are part of this pack, you know that I feed my dogs raw food, raw, complete and balanced meat, bone, and organ meals. And that is the most ideal way for your dog to eat to ensure they're not getting too many carbs and sugars and starches and preservatives and toxins. And it's basically mimicking the way that they would have eaten in the wild. But that is one of the most important things when caring for your doodle, is picking the right food. If you have questions about that, I am more than happy to help you. In fact, I would love to talk to you about transitioning your dog to eating a full or partial raw diet. Just comment down below, send me a DM on my Instagram at Rachel Fasaro, whatever it is, however you want to contact me, you get to me and I'd love to help you. So now for the most important thing that you can do to ensure that you're caring for and loving your doodle in the best way possible is, drum roll, what is it, Finn? What is the best thing that they can do? Exactly. You can rescue your doodle. Yep, you heard me right, y'all. My mission is to save all the damn dogs, and I do that by promoting rescuing, adopting, fostering, superior nutrition through raw feeding. And the best thing you can do for any doodle out there is to find one that has been surrendered or abandoned that needs to be rehomed through a rescue group or a shelter. And there are tons of them, from puppies to seniors to cute fluffy ones to scruffy looking ones. There are many out there that need a home, and you can make a difference by giving a homeless doodle a home, just like we did with Finn. If you have any other tips, I'd love to hear them down below, because we are a community and I love learning from you, just like you're learning from Finn. And I just want to thank you guys so damn much for supporting this. You guys are, yeah, my heart. We're a family here. We're fam bam. So comment below. I'd love to learn from you. I'm sure others would as well. Let's get the comment section going hot. Please don't knock over the light, Finn. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram. I would love to connect with you. Y'all have been sending me messages there a lot more lately. Like, it's been daily, which is freaking so cool. You guys are so cool. I love it. Like, you're asking questions, you're connecting with me. Y'all are everything. You know that emoji? That's how you make me feel. I hope that you have a beautiful day. Bye. If you want to see the video of me bringing him home and his story, because he is a rescue dog from a rescue organization, you can click the link up here.